They just got up there.
What's going on, YouTube? We're back at the very same mall that we did the screaming. And today we're gonna do a bunch of other stuff. So just be ready for a bunch of stuff. Don't focus on one thing. So what we're trying to do today is we found a bunch of pranks, and we want to say the first video was very successful from like small YouTuber standpoint. So we want to say like, you know, thank you, because it was actually very successful. It was a lot more successful than we thought it was going to be anyway. But that's it for now. Right now for the intro, we're going to think of the pranks while we're walking around the mall. So, you know, just get ready for it.
But today we are back because, you know, we're going to try
back. We're better and we're doing more shit.
The GILFs, the MILFs.
The lesbians, everyone.
Just because like the last video was such a success for small YouTubers, we're gonna scream again.
I'm pretty sure you should. You should have just never done that, man. If you didn't do that, we wouldn't have been in this position.
Dude, we could have told.
No, I don't get why you had to do that, man. Like, what the?
Get a good angle.
Can we play the piano?
One thing that you don't know about us is
white.
We have
white
in the end. If we don't say so ourselves. So.
For me personally, my grandfather is from Bulgaria, kind of.
Esad.
I don't know this one.
Here, close the door. Close the door.
Get in here.
No, just stay here then. Okay, just stay here and close the door.
Shoot.
Hold it up.
Shoot.
Hold it up.
Ain't no way. The route we
can. My man. Oh, yes. And your
pants. Oh, shit.
Oh, my God. Damn.
Ah! I'm Batman. I'm gonna fall off, dude. You're gonna. Alright, we're gonna vlog some moments up here. Dude, like, look how big this roof is. Like,
hey,
oh my god.
Our cameraman, he didn't come up here because he's a bitch, but he's gonna call us just in case there's security. So immediately if the phone starts ringing, we're pulling out the camera.
So, Shugs. We're walking this way right now. It doesn't look that big, but it's actually so big. So, boys, we running over here now.
They just got up there. Yeah.
Yeah, boys, you got Smith here. This is our view, our semi view. This is not the best view. We're about to go up there, you know. Yeah, so we found this and we about to do this, I guess.
I want the roof and this kid is climbing up.
Come do the Batman pose.
He's a Batman. Yo.
Oh my
god. Guys, 1 million likes and I push him off the roof.
No, that's like a build. That's like right now, do it.
Looking over the view like Batman. Is the city in good hands?
What's going on, YouTube? This is you 4 months after the video was recorded.
You guys, as you can see, I got...
I got the braces off. I got the prime. I got both my braces off.
Here's the full rundown of what happened. It was just supposed to be a normal day at the mall. We were chilling, killing. We were doing some pranks. You know all the details. So yeah, basically, the video just kind of, you know, just stops.
Yeah,
right? And here's the reason on why that happened.
So let me start off. As you guys know, after that, we went down the ladder again, and then we just started to make our way back. I know this is when, like, everything goes downhill. Like, this is where shit hits the fan. Like, but as I was walking back, I just see these two big security guards just... like speed walking towards us in this formation.
And they're basically,
so you know what I did?
He turns around. And I turned around
and I sprinted back. I like jumped the thing, and I told these two kids. Mehmet's not here with us right now because he's working, but I told Mehmet and Nick, "Yo, dude, there's two people up here." No, we didn't even have anywhere to run.
We didn't have anywhere to run.
We were just panicking basically.
At this point, we were just like,
Then. They started escorting us.
We get back down.
Yeah, we found a way we got up.
There's like a
It's just like one. It's like one sheriff officer.
But he's got like bulletproof armor. Yeah. He pulls out a notepad and he's like, "What's your name?" I say my name. Esau says his name. We get them a Mehmet.
Oh
he's
my
like,
god.
He's like, "What's your name?" And he's like, "Mehmet." And the cop's like, "Mamax, Macmeth, Math."
Yeah. After he got our information, bro, he like led us into like this like back rooms type of place. It was so hidden, like he opened like five different rooms. Yeah. And then once we were finally in,
there's another black dude with glasses, and he's like he comes into his chair and he's like, "Hey boss, got the court date ready for you, just go ahead and print out the few things." Yeah. And then the other dudes are just like, "All right, so let's write down your information here, so we give them your information." They're just like, "So mom,
you guys know what you did was illegal, right?"
And obviously, we didn't know about that.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, as we said in the video, we just saw the stairs open and we're like,
"We're going."
Yeah, we might as well just take the opportunity. Anyways, when we walked in, like we said, there was like a monitor, like as big as like, I don't even know how to.
It was huge.
It was like, and then on that monitor, there was like 60 different views. It had all the cameras in the entire building, and like the black guy with like the short hair was like looking through it, and he's like, "Yeah, so the court date is ready." And at this point, the mall officer was asking like for our information. You know, we technically did get in trouble legally, but I forgot to mention this kid Smith. As we were getting escorted back down, he was like begging me to pull out the camera.
Yeah, I know, dude, because I know none of you guys were coming. And again, here's the thing. Since we didn't get that on the video, we do not care if you guys don't believe us. We really don't care. We could care less. And that's one of those reasons.
Yeah. So after we were done with everything, I think the guy said we were going to get fined like $200. And
I don't think that actually
ended up happening. Yeah, that never happened. But he did try to send us to court. That didn't work. Instead, we got sent to an interrogation center 2 months after the incident. Yeah, we got sent over there.
No, his last name is like Coop. So we'll just call him Coop.
He was
Mr. N. Coop over here. He was the chillest guy.
Yeah. He was our intervention specialist. I think that was like the last guy the cop wanted us to talk with.
I remind you guys that is the most male Karen if I've ever seen. If you guys are over there by Polaris, do not get into any altercations or else you're gonna have to deal with that guy.
But
anyway, our boy Mr. N. Coop over here. Our boy Mr. N. Coop.
We're in the room, the conference room. Our parents are here. He's
basically, again, you know, he wasn't there on the scene the day that, you know, we got in trouble. So, you know, we kind of had to explain why we did it and how we did it again. And then we did that, and, you know, he's basically like, so basically here's your punishment. It was a lot.
So we got our sentence there, and it was basically just a 500-word essay about, like, how our goals impact.
And we have, like, about, like, a month to do it.
Yeah, it was really chill. And so after we did that, we had to Gmail Coop. And then our case got dismissed after that. And we're all good right now. We don't have anything on our record.
Yeah, anyway, guys, we will not be leaving you like we did for those 4 months. All right, season two.
Yeah, that's about it.